Good morning. Today I'll be talking about Thomas Hardy's Tess of the Durbervilles as a great pessimistic novel. Please have a paper and a pen so that you can jot down the important points pertaining to the text. So here we begin. Hardy's Tess of the Durbervilles is generally called a great pessimistic novel. Hardy is said to be pessimist about the governance of the world. Early in life, he rejected Christian belief in a benevolent and omnipotent God. In Tess, he tells justice was done and the president of the immortals had ended his sport with Tess. The whole span of Tess's life is full of tortures which seem to be carried out by fate or destiny relentlessly. Hence, Tess is regarded as a pessimistic novel through and through. The novel appears to be pessimistic because it is the most pathetic novel of Hardy. In Tess, pity reigns supreme. As Joseph Warren Beach observes, it is remarkable that never once in the dozen novels which preceded Tess had Hardy ever offered so direct an invitation to tears as here we meet so many times. The most intense pathetic scenes are scattered all through the novel. The poverty of the Durbervilles family with half dozen little captures, the unfortunate death of the prince, Tess's seduction, the death of the child Sorrow, Tess's desertion by Angel, her hardships of the winter labor, Flintcomb Ash Farm, the prosecutions of Farmer Groby, the adverse comments of Angel's brothers, and Tess's unfortunate encounter with Alec. All these pathetic scenes follow one after the other. They evoke feelings of pity for the sufferer. But more than pathetic scenes which give an impression of the novelist's pessimistic approach, the novel appears to be pessimistic because in it, the heroine Tess frequently expresses views on life. While riding with her younger brother on the wagon in the night, Tess tells him that they live on a blighted star. At the Talbothays dairy, Tess feels that it is a mishap to be alive. When Angel asks her why she looks misery-ridden, she tells him, "My life looks as if it had been wasted for want of chances. I feel what a nothing I am. I am like the poor queen of Sheba who lived in the Bible. There is no more spirit in me." Throughout the novel, Tess expresses such gloomy ideas about life. Then Hardy himself projects pessimistic view through his comments on various situations and events. His comment on Tess's situation during her first encounter with Alec shows the precariousness of existence. Hardy also asks as an unsolved question about the unwanted social setup, why it was that upon this beautiful feminine tissue, sensitive as gossamer and practically blank as snow, as yet there should have been traced such a coarse pattern as it was doomed to receive. Why so often the coarse appropriates the finer thing? The wrong man, the woman, the wrong woman, the man, many thousand years of analytical philosophy have failed to explain to our sense of order and order. And finally, Hardy concludes the game of God with Tess, where he writes, "The president of immortals had ended his sport with Tess." All such remarks of Hardy show that he is pessimistic about the governance of universe. But Hardy has no pessimistic approach towards human beings. His tragic novels, Jude the Obscure, The Mayor of Casterbridge, and Tess of the Durbervilles give an impression that the tragic heroes and heroines do lack in the heroic courage to brave life with an indomitable spirit. It is rightly said that Hardy's pessimism is always elevating and seldom depressing. Hardy's novels, particularly Tess, appear to be pessimistic, but certainly Hardy's art cannot be called pessimistic. The final impression left by the novel is that of power, insight, sympathy, and hopefulness. Even though Tess dies in the end, there is an implied hope that the world will become happier when the laws of man are made to conform more closely to the laws or impulses of nature. So this is all about Hardy's treatment of pessimism in the novel Tess of the Durbervilles. So the point to be noted here is, even though Hardy was a pessimist by nature, he saw life to be full of misery, and for him, happiness is but an occasional episode in the general drama of pain. But the characters of Hardy are very lively, and they present how man is actually captured by fate and destiny, and how becomes a prey to it. I hope this video proves to be of help to each one of you. Please do like, share, and subscribe to the channel. I upload the literature content on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Please click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day ahead.